important to document this for the sake of our children. All adventures that have happened within human history have been obliterated into ashes and dust. Now, with our 20th century technology, can we document our trials and errors, our mistakes and adventures, so they will infinitely live forever?
But there was something that you said after that that was all mumbled, and we have no clue what it was.
Yeah, I told...
Tell them we're waiting in the fireworks lot.
That's straight up retarded.
That's Dan, right?
Just start pulling out.
That's why we're going to New Hampshire, because Cloutier has a house up here?
Yeah.
Dude.
It's not his.
So what the deal is, like, this driveway goes all the way down,
yes.
Like, a mile, and then once you get to the end of the mile, it stops off and there's a snowbank, and then it's another mile to the house through snow. Things like the U-Haul will not make it and are definitely
really?
Going to get stuck, and things are going to happen. So let's just wait and see what happens.
So what do you think is smart at this point?
Well, this is a good spot.
Can we walk from here to there?
Yes, but it's about 2 miles, and we have to carry a lot of equipment.
All right, man, start directing. The good news is we got Roman candles at the fireworks store.
That's all you got?
He gets fucking like 3 Roman candles and 1 box that's gonna explode.
We're good to go, and I'm really psyched to be acting in this movie. I'm gonna test them out for the first time. Success.
How do they work, Jake?
I don't know who this guy is. He kind of looks like Topher.
Shut up.
We're gonna send a scout party down there. See what we have.
Everything cool back here?
Yeah. We're just getting ready to cut down a tree that fell in the way. Tree saw. These roads are really unkempt during the winter because nobody comes up here. But there's a tree that's not fallen completely, but it's fallen enough that will block any car's progress on the way in. It's not that far.
The 1970s, there was a filmmaker named Werner Herzog. His belief was that, ideally, when filmmaking, it is important to live on the brink of death. Here, out in nature, we are battling the cosmic forces while sacrificing to make our art. Right out here, in God's green earth, this is where it's all gonna happen. You can cut now. You guys got a man up now.
All right, Jake, we'll be back.
I'll see you guys soon.
Frankie, Godspeed.
But can I get everybody's job starting with Jesse?
Well, I'm an Aries. I'm an actor. I act things.
I am the director of photography.
And this is probably the only chance we'll get to talk to you, right?
Yes, I'll be busy for the whole shoot.
Mikey?
Boom.
I am the second AC currently.
And of course, Dan Cohen, our esteemed director. Okay. So we actually made it to the stop where the vehicle can make it, but there's... There's about a foot of snow. You can't drive through it. It looks like they're thinking about shoveling it or some retarded bullshit like that.
There's local plow services in town.
I think we just need to shovel the initial space, or that's the theory that we've developed.
To get the vehicles.
And then once it's in the snow, we're going to try to
It's safe to walk.
Yeah. But I mean, if we can get the U-Haul.
If we can just knock this fucking thing down, we might be able to drive through here?
It means that we have... a 90% chance of making it to here. And then from there,
a few feet forward.
I think our odds are maybe 85% that we're gonna get stuck right there.
You go there in, you go. And then immediately go as far as you think you can go, then pull out immediately, and then we'll make further.
No fear.
And we're done.
Ooh.
We got it. No?
Well, it's not gonna.
Well, that's further than last time.
How far the walk is, they got comparably not very far at all.
Two roads diverged in a yellow world.
It's Kurt.
The legend of Bigfoot.
The Sasquatch.
Want me to do something funny to
it? Oh, and it's part of the digital age of technology.
What about six people? Can six people lift a generator?
We should have gotten a sled.
Yeah, but Jesse, imagine six people carrying this enormous thing through 2 feet of snow. Get like a wooden sled or something.
Two wooden sleds.
At least something to just like...
cheap. You can get plastic ones for like $30.
That would probably shatter a plastic one.
You don't seem that stressed, Scotty.
Is that true?
That's what I'm saying all the time. So there, and apparently it's like a 20-25 minute walk.
Do you know that we need to basically leave this location? It's gonna get cold. We have no home base. We have nowhere warm to rest. We're gonna have a fatigued film crew with nowhere to sleep, nowhere to use the bathroom aside from a tree. Basically, we have no safety right now. Our group is completely disbanded, and we're trying to collect ourselves.
I think what we need to do is call everybody, get everybody in one spot, and talk. No,
he's been MIA
the whole time.
You've been gone.
I've been walking.
And people and I didn't make here it have there. Been getting pretty pissed.
Wow. They're pissed?
Oh, and Mikey. Yeah. Mikey's probably the pissiest. Like,
Mikey's about to abandon this shoot. I'm putting my money now on nothing being shot. Yeah. If anything, one or two of the cars will be leaving, and there'll be a skeleton crew that does something.
Tell me what happened again.
Dan just called Mike and told him that he's going to have a guy come and plow it in half an hour.
No.
I think he's.
I've been trying to call him for the past half hour. He's not.
Well, why don't you and I tell the camera what happened to us on the way?
Well, we were told by these guys with $100,000 pieces of equipment that it wasn't doable, that they would get stuck themselves.
No, yeah. You can't be recording this right now because we actually have to make decisions here. I'm sorry.
He doesn't have anything to do with it.
But this
have nothing to do with
tell
it.
Him to fucking cut the plow. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing it. Peter's not doing it. The camera team just dropped off.
Okay.
Did you drive this car here?
Yeah, I drove it here.
Well, we're going to need to
I recorded that. Wow, so it's kind of difficult to explain what's been going on here, but because there's a lot of arguing and it's really intense. But basically, the camera crew is quitting. They don't want any part of this. They're all going home and they're saying that there's no way a film can get shot. So it's pretty hilarious. Well, you missed an awful lot.
Well, we started this out. This is the biggest camera crew I had ever worked on.
We decided that we were going to get frostbite if we stayed out there and even tried to shoot. So we came over to this cabin, which is a mile-long walk in the freezing snow. We're all freezing.
This was poorly planned.
Did we see this like 2 or 3 days ago? Didn't we all call it?
Yeah.
Weren't you the one that ran?
But you, Frankie, were shirtless and running around the snow.
That was before things got really bad. When we needed to use extension cords to pull vehicles out of the snow. That's when things got a little rough.
Everyone!
Turn the music up. Dan has something to say. We had a really shitty day yesterday.
Today.
Tomorrow is another day. The sun will be up. It'll be warmer.
But not warm.
Probably not warm. We'll be well rested. We'll be stupid and idealistic again.
I don't know about well rested.
And hopefully things will go a lot better.
But not
if they do not, I want everyone to cry and quit at once. I know you're all just as unhappy as the people who did quit, and I really respect you all for not giving up.
The plague!
How did that happen?
I banged it against, I don't remember, it was when we were like carrying shit and stuff.
My ex-wife.
This might have been a bad time to tell you, but I heard that like a bunch of mental patients just escaped from this abandoned mental hospital.
Oh, you're looking at my dick!
How do you think you did today, acting-wise?
Pretty good. I acted like I wanted to be there.
Like calls the cops or something. Oh wait, how would they ever?
How would they get? Yeah.
It's in the national.
Is it recording?
Yeah.
Dude, today was fucking ridiculous, man.
What, the whole day? Why was it ridiculous?
We're driving 3 hours up here to shoot an alien movie. Why is it in the snow at night?
You want an actual answer?
Yeah.
Okay, it's day two, and we haven't shot 1 foot of film. It's pretty hardcore. I will remember this forever. So sleeping was pretty comfortable, right?
Sleeping sucked.
But now we have the splendor of nature.
I, for one, was freezing ass cold all night.
Kind of nestled a little bit. There were a couple times where it was like, hey.
Oh, damn it.
Isn't too bad.
Nothing about you isn't funny.
Let's see it.
Holy shit.
Well, that's just me, I guess, and I'm okay with
that. It's
a punt. Okay, get that up over my shoulder.
Now, in colder climates, they can't really fit into their costumes because the blood vessels restrict.
My tiggies are cold.
How you feeling?
Someone was laughing. Like, okay.
Are your tiggies so cold?
Actually, yeah. You know, practice. Yeah. They were right. Last night.
My tiggies! My tiggies are cold!
3, 5, 4, 5!
My tiggies!
Excuse me, sir. You can't be here. This is a restricted area. You must be Sergeant Biggs. It's enough of this shit! Doctor, no! We should do that again. Okay, yeah. That's enough of this shit! Doctor, no!